Yeah, I know you're no stranger to a good scrap, but that was a fantastic one. How are you feeling after that?
I feel amazing, sir. Honored to fight for the greatest organization ever made, and that's the Kevin Aguilar you're always going to see, the Angel of Death, right there every time.
What was it feeling like going into this fight? I know you said yesterday on social media, like, I waited so long to get here. I don't care about him missing weight or anything. I mean, what was the emotion like just getting into the cage tonight?
I want to perform and stand in front of the greatest crowd and the greatest organization and show to the whole world what I'm capable of. And I feel like I went out there and proved it tonight, even on short notice. And even though my opponent missed weight, it doesn't matter to me as long as I get to step in there and show the world what I have to offer as far as the fight game goes. And that's Kevin Aguilar you're always going to see.
Were there any nerves tonight ahead of the fight?
Man, I was nervous because, I was going to go into a fight with one of the greatest athletes in the sport. Because this sport only produces the greatest athletes. So I was nervous, and I'm like, oh, man. Now, it was a awesome feeling to get in there and scrap out with some of the world's greatest.
Yeah, it was a great fight. You hurt him pretty bad in the first. I want to ask you about that. You hit him with a straight and then an uppercut, and it looked like he was almost done, but you didn't rush the finish. I'm curious, I mean, did you know how bad you had him hurt? Like, in retrospect, do you wish you would have rushed? Or, was that on purpose going, maybe out of respect for his toughness or whatever, that you didn't want to burn yourself out?
I saw him get dazed from those shots there in the first round. And you never want to rush in, or I'm trained never to rush in, because he can catch me with a crazy punch, put me out. Even though I have him on the ropes, I have to compose myself, step back, think about it, and then keep attacking with the same intensity, but never rush in blindly to finish my opponent.
Last thing for me, what do you do for the next 3 hours while you sit around and wait to figure out if you're cashing 50 G's? Because that seems to be a fight of the night leader in the clubhouse right now, but there's 6 fights left, so what do you do from here?
Man, I'm just going to sit back, enjoy the show, let it sink in that I fought for the greatest organization, and hopefully everybody out there puts on a great performance, fights that people want to see and just scream about for years. That's what I hope for the rest of these fighters, but 50 G's doesn't sound bad. I'm in it for the blood, the intensity. I'm in it for the fight solely. I just remember just a few minutes ago that I'm getting paid for this.
What do you want to do next? You have another name? I mean, obviously, you just went through a battle. I'm sure you want to rest a little bit, but is there a name or a date or a location that makes sense for you next?
Man, whenever the organization wants to call me back up, I'm ready to put on another great show.
Talked about money, you're actually going to get a little bit of his purse as well
and
see his weight.
Oh, yeah. I forget all about the money aspect of it. He missed weight, so he does have to give up some of his purse, which, that sucks for him, but, I'm not going to argue with it. That's the name of the game. I mean, you got to make weight or you get some of your purse taken away.
When he missed, was there any question for you about whether or not you were going to take the fight?
Absolutely not. Yeah. Never a thought about not taking the fight. He did miss weight. That's bad on him for taking half of his some of his money. But, I was too excited to not take the fight. That's just something that we don't do. We don't not take fights.
If you had to say something to your mom and your father, what would you say to them?
Mamá, papá, gracias por dar la pelea y gané. Soy campeón como me criaron y ahí voy a traer la ganada para atrás. Y ahí vamos a hablar muy pronto. Los quiero mucho. And my brothers, Juan Jr., los quiero, cabrones, porque y'all punks. No, nací aquí, de Texas.
Okay, okay.
Pero mis papás y mis hermanos son de México. San Luis Potosí.
Oh, gracias.
Sí. Cool. Toda la raza allá, gracias.
Thank you.
Hey, thank y'all. Are we good?